Hello, and thank you for joining us for another exciting episode of Inventor's Quick Tips. Today, we are talking about a difference between patents and trade secrets. We'll introduce some of the key differences between them and give some points to consider when deciding which is best for a given situation. One thing to remember is that to patent something means to disclose it. In order to have a valid patent, that patent must teach how to make and use the invention. The patent terminology for that is called enablement. Typically, the inventive details must be disclosed. Therefore, others will know how your invention works. And there are certain situations where we'd rather that the world did not know how our invention works. So let's think about trade secrets. Trade secrets can last indefinitely, as long as you can keep the thing secret. Whereas a patent gives you about 20 years, tops. And a trade secret is relatively cheap compared to a patent, in that pretty much it just involves keeping the particular thing secret. However, there are some downsides to trade secrets. Trade secrets are vulnerable to reverse engineering. You do have to make efforts to keep security throughout the life of the trade secret. So, for example, in a company, the trade secret should basically be handled on a need-to-know basis. So if only 5 employees out of 100 need to work with the trade secret, then only those employees should know about it. Also, a trade secret could be legitimately discovered and patented by somebody else. So that's always a risk that you face. So here's a key question for consideration. How easy is it to reverse engineer your invention? Let's look at a few technology types. Most inventions fall into at least one of these types: mechanical, electronic, chemical composition, software, or a process. Now, basically, with a mechanical invention, it's easy to reverse engineer. So in most cases, you simply cannot keep a mechanical invention secret. If it's a product you are going to sell, say a pencil sharpener, for example, anybody who's inclined could take apart that pencil sharpener and figure out how it works. So for most mechanical inventions, a patent is a more appropriate form of protection as opposed to a trade secret. Now for some of these technology types, it's usually possible to reverse engineer with a certain amount of effort. So electronics, for example, can be disassembled, probed, and for those who are skilled and motivated, integrated circuits can be examined, and it may be possible to reverse engineer a chip. In fact, semiconductor companies file many, many patent applications each year because they know that others who are skilled in that field could reverse engineer things with the tools that they have. Chemical compositions can be analyzed through a variety of techniques to gain information regarding compounds and the percentages present of each compound in a given material. Software can be disassembled by professionals to learn the inner workings of many software implemented inventions. So while these technology types are typically a little bit more difficult than mechanical inventions to reverse engineer, it is still possible for someone who's motivated to reverse engineer these in many cases. Now, processes is one field where it can be difficult to reverse engineer them. Not necessarily impossible, but depending on the process, it can be difficult. And in some cases, a process, it may make sense to keep it as a trade secret. We're going to show you a contrived example next. So this is a fictional example, but just to illustrate the point. Let's say that I have a company that makes steel beams for construction. And I discover or realize that if I do this post-process, after I make the steel beam, if I heat it at 800 degrees Celsius for 30 seconds, and then I cool it in a water tank at 4 degrees Celsius for 5 seconds, I discover that this gives the beam some improved properties for use as a construction material. Well, assuming I can keep this process secret, it may be to my advantage to keep it as a trade secret and not file a patent application on it. Reason being, if I file a patent application on it and it becomes a patent, at some point, this process is going to be known to the world. And my patent, in the best case, will last about 20 years. And after that, it's free for everybody to use. However, if I could keep this secret for 50 years, then I would have the competitive advantage, or my company would have the competitive advantage going forward. So in certain situations, a trade secret may make sense, especially if it's not easy for someone to figure out that I did this process on my steel beams. In other words, if a competitor gets his hands on one of my steel beams, would they be able to figure out that I performed this specific process on it easily? And if the answer is no, then a trade secret might be worth considering. So again, let's go over the key questions. How hard would it be to reverse engineer or discover the secret? So that is a key question, right? If somebody could easily look at it or take it apart and figure it out, then a trade secret's not appropriate. If it's difficult to figure out, then a trade secret may be appropriate. How beneficial would it be to keep it secret? In other words, does the trade secret or potential trade secret give you a key competitive advantage? So for example, in the steel beam example, that process, at least in our fictional story, gives us a clear competitive advantage. And so we want to keep that secret. It's better off keeping it secret than trying to patent it in that case. Another question is it even possible to keep it secret? Okay, so that's sort of like goes back to question one, how hard would it be to reverse engineer? If it's not even possible to keep it secret, that is, if somebody could discover it by looking at your invention, then the trade secret is pretty much a non-starter. Who are your likely competitors and how capable or motivated will they be to access your invention? For example, if you're dealing with semiconductors, a semiconductor competitor may have a lot of resources, equipment, and money, and they will try to reverse engineer things. So in certain cases, especially with when a lot of money is involved, competitors may throw resources at trying to reverse engineer it. So even something that might seem difficult to reverse engineer, it may still be possible. In that case, a patent application may be a more appropriate course of action. So in summary, if something is difficult or impossible to keep secret, consider a patent application for protection. If it is possible to keep it secret and it also provides a competitive advantage to know that secret, then consider keeping it as a trade secret. So hopefully this brief introduction gave you some points to consider regarding patent applications versus trade secrets. Thanks again for checking out this episode, and we'll see you next time.